روح جبريل will be standing in his place and the angels in their rows they don't speak unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands them to speak. They
do exactly something right now
as they're told.
All right. No, is it talking about Angel Gabriel? What is up, guys? Your boy Real G. I'm back with another reaction video called, you know, Rare Things About Angel Gabriel You Didn't Know. We're gonna check this out and see what it's all about. If you're new to my channel, subscribe with the notification buttons on. Let's check it out. And don't forget to subscribe to my second channel. You will find the link in the description below. All right, guys, let's go.
Now, dear brothers and sisters, what's our relationship with Jibreel alayhi salam right now? You know, one of my favorite things about teaching this class in particular, subhanAllah, one of my favorite things about talking about Jibreel, as opposed to talking about some of the companions of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is that you can actually interact with Jibreel right now. You know how? You know how? The Prophet ﷺ, he says in an authentic hadith. And actually, Anas radiallahu anhu said...
He's talking about Jibreel. Well, who is Jibreel? That's a normal question. So, I don't know. You should leave a comment below. You tell me who is Jibreel before we start. So I'm going to understand what he's talking about. I don't know who is Jibreel. Because I'm not a Muslim, man. I'm a Christian, so.
And Abu Talha says, one time the Prophet ﷺ, all of a sudden his face was just full of joy. So he said to him, Ya Rasulullah, what is it? May Allah keep you happy. He said, Ja'ani Jibreel. Jibreel just came to me. فَقَالْ أَمَا يُرْضِيكَ يَا مُحَمَّدْ أَنْ لَا يُصَلِّي عَلَيْكَ أَحَدْ مِنْ أُمَّتِكَ إِلَّا صَلَّيْتُ عَلَيْهِ عَشْرًا. Aren't you pleased, though, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that no one says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam except that I send salawat upon them 10 times? Jibreel alayhi salam as well. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Allah and the angels send their salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when you send the salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Jibreel alayhi salam responds to you as well. Allah responds to you and Jibreel alayhi salam responds to you. So you want Jibreel alayhi salam to say your name right now? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. What about now? Does he stop coming to the earth now? Is he gone? Does he never come down anymore? Actually, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one time he came out, and this is a hadith narrated by Muawiyah radiallahu anhu. We were just sitting in the masjid and we were talking, and suddenly the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came out to us, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to us, what are you talking about? And he said, Ya Rasulullah, we're just talking about how lucky we are, how blessed we are to be guided to Islam. The Prophet ﷺ said, is that all you were talking about? They said, Ya Rasulullah, all we were talking about is our days of ignorance and how we're blessed to be guided to Islam. The Prophet ﷺ said, don't worry. He said, I just wanted to come to you because Atani Jibreel. Jibreel just came to me. And he said, those companions of yours that are sitting out in the masjid, أخبرني أن الله يباهي بكم الملائكة. Jibreel just came to me and said, Allah is bragging about them to the angels right now. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ إِذَا حَبَّ عَبْدًا نَادَى جِبْرِيلٌ. When Allah loves someone, He calls Jibreel and He says, يَا جِبْرِيلْ إِنِّي أُحِبُّ فُلَانٍ. Oh Jibreel, I love so-and-so. فَأَحِبَّ. Love that person as well. فَيُحِبُّهُ جِبْرِيلٌ. Jibreel loves you. Jibreel doesn't need to know anything else about you. He just needs to know Allah loves you. And if Allah loves you, that's enough for Jibreel to love you as well. So Jibreel goes and calls all of the angels and the inhabitants of the heavens and says, يَا مَلَائِكَ يَا أَهْلَ السَّمَاءِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ فُلَانٍ. Allah loves this person, so love him as well. So all of the inhabitants of the heavens love him as well. SubhanAllah. Think about your name being said in this conversation between Allah and Jibreel and Jibreel and the angels. And think about how many likes that is, right? You're talking about trillions of angels that love you. They don't just like you, they love you. وَيُوضَعُ لَهُ الْقَبُولُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. And Allah places acceptance for that person in the hearts of the people. That's Jibreel alayhi salam. He continues to be amongst the angels that come down to the gatherings that remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we ask Allah that He be amongst us right now. That's the question I ask myself every time I teach this class. I'm like, how amazing would it be if Jibreel was actually here right now? If Jibreel alayhi salam is actually amongst us reporting our name to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in Ramadan, what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَالرُّوحُ فِيهَا. The angels come down and none other than Jibreel is amongst them. This is in the Arabic language, Al-Khas al Am, specifying someone amongst them. They came and Jibreel was amongst them. Subhanallah. So when you're praying Taraweeh on that night, or you're reading Quran or doing dhikr, how do you know Jibreel is not the one coming to your house and reporting your name to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That's something to aim for. That Jibreel comes to my house and reports my name to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that night of Laylatul Qadr. And we should have that husn al-dhan in Allah, that good expectation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's very possible, and that yes, a lowly person like me, Jibreel alayhi salam, could be sent to report my name back to my creator subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah, even, you know, every time you see al-ruh wal-malaika, al-malaika wal-ruh, the angels, and Jibreel is specified amongst them. You know, even in some cultures, there's a special mention of Jibreel alayhi salam just in our everyday language. Some of the Arabs, whenever they finish the food and there's the du'a, Sallat alaykum al-malaika, may the angels send their prayers upon you, some of them would say, illa Jibreel ba'd al-shay. Except for Jibreel after the tea, right? It's like there's this recognition, it's inherent inside of us, that Jibreel is greater than the rest of the angels. But you know what? What does Allah tell us? يَوْمَ تَقُومُ الرُّوحُ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ صَفًّا لَا يَتَكَلَّمُونَ. On that day, and Allah puts ar-ruh this time before the angels, that even ar-ruh, Jibreel, will be standing in his place, and the angels in their rows, they don't speak unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands them to speak. They
do exactly something right now.
As they're told.
Alright. No, is it talking about Angel Gabriel? Okay, that's what it's calling Jibreel. Okay, alright. You should leave a comment below so and see if I'm right. He is talking about Angel Gabriel. Or Jibreel. They call it, you don't know, if Muslim they call it Jibreel. And Christian they call it Angel Gabriel. I don't know. Maybe he's the...
Would we meet Jibreel alayhi salam on the Day of Judgment? Hudhayfa radiallahu anhu narrates an authentic athar that Jibreel is the angel that will be in charge of al-mizan, the scales. May Allah make it easy for us on that day, the scales. You would actually see Jibreel alayhi salam on the scales on that day. What about in Jannah? Can you be with Jibreel? Can you actually be with Jibreel telling him about the story of Jibreel and the class that you took? And can you talk to Jibreel in Jannah? Can you be with him? Ra'aytu Ja'far. I saw Ja'far radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa huwa yatiru fil jannati ma'al malaika. And he was flying in Jannah with the angels. You could get your pair of wings and you could fly with Jibreel alayhi salam in Jannah. We know that that exists. We know that that place is there. But I want to end this night, dear brothers and sisters, with something to make it a little bit more personal now. Jibreel is the wali of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the angels. Jibreel is his wali. Who is your wali from the angels? It's a powerful question. And what do I mean by that? The Prophet ﷺ said, every night before you go to sleep, an angel comes down to you. And he says, ikhtim bi khayr. Ikhtim bi khayr. Ikhtim bi khayr. End your night well. End your night well. End your night well. End it with the remembrance of God. End it with an act of charity. End it with a word of kindness. End it with something good. End it with dhikr. End it with wudu. You know? End it with something good, because you might not wake up. End well. The angel prompts you, end well. And the Prophet ﷺ said, a shaitan on the other hand says, ikhtim bi shar, end in evil. And the Prophet ﷺ said, if you listen to that angel, ikhtim bi khayr, and you end your night well, the angel spends the entire night with you, seeking forgiveness for you, and praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on you. Until you wake up in the morning, and the angel says, iftah bi khayr, iftah bi khayr, iftah bi khayr. Start your day off well. Start your day off well. Start your day off well. And the Prophet ﷺ said, if he starts his day off well, the angel spends the entire day with him, seeking forgiveness for him and asking Allah to have mercy on him. That's your wali from the angels. SubhanAllah, I was just telling Ustad Nu'man what he recited in Salat al-Maghrib. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبَشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاءُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. The angels come down to the believer as he's passing away. The wali, your awliya from the malaika, your guardians, your protectors, the ones who loved you and were with you your entire life from the angels, they come to you just as Jibreel came to the Prophet ﷺ, and they say, don't worry, don't grieve. We were your awliya in this world and in the hereafter as well. Come out to Jannah. Allah has promised it to you. And the Prophet ﷺ said the believing soul would jump out of this body of joy. It will come out in happiness. SubhanAllah. Whereas some people are to the opposite. Wal-iyadu billah. Now I want you to think about that for a moment, dear brothers and sisters, and recognize that the angels are the last thing that we see before we come into this world, and the first thing we see as we're leaving it. In fact, from the tests of this world is that it's the only time in our existence that the angels are concealed from us. Because if we saw them, none of us would act the way that we do. But we choose to surround ourselves in our daily lives with angels, be it Jibreel or other angels, or with shayateen. We make that choice every single moment of our lives, who to surround ourselves with. May Allah allow us to be joined with the malaika, with the angels. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to be in the highest companionship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with the angels, with the siddiqeen, the shuhada, with the righteous. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us for our shortcomings, and may Allah surround us with the malaika and allow us to end our lives in khayr, allow us to end our lives in good. The brothers and sisters, jazakumullah khayran for coming out.
Yo, that's a strong word here. That's a strong message. Not bad. This is a strong message right here. This is a strong word. I like it. It's a very strong message. With that being said, if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, share, subscribe to my channel, my second channel too. Thank you guys for watching. See you in the next video. Peace out.